Hi there, I'm Michael and give them the Fiddlershop.com, and welcome to this tutorial on the first violin part, or first instrument part, I suppose, if you're playing viola or cello, for the Fiddlerman Christmas group project based on I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas. Now, the melody, you can just play it twice through in first position, but you can also do the second time in octave higher, and I'm gonna do that. And if you do it an octave higher on violin, it's going to require quite a bit of shifting. So if you're comfortable with shifting, take a look at it. But if you'd like to just stay in first position and just play the melody, and then just stick on the first part as written. All right, I'm going to play it for you, and then I've got some advice and suggestions on how to practice.
One, and one, two, ready, play.
All right, so I've got just a couple things to point out. Again, you can just play the first part two times as written and play it in the same octave both times. That's perfectly fine. If you want the challenge, though, to play it an octave higher a second time, then you're gonna need both pages and only play the higher octave on the second time. So there are some open strings, there's some open A strings in this part, so we really wanna make sure that our instrument is in tune before we start, and we're gonna tune to 440. So make sure your tuner is set to that so that everything sounds nice, fits nicely together. Now the bowings are pretty straightforward in this part. They are, however, just a suggestion. If you need to slur something or break something up, you can do that. But in general, if you can try to stick to the bowings, it's okay. Something I just noticed is a little funny is in measure 16 or so, the up bow is, it's just a finale issue where it just pushed the up bow kind of far into the middle of the bar. And you can just change on the beat, which is fine, or if you want to stagger bowing and change bows somewhere else in the bar, that's also nice. So that's my comment on bowings. Let's see what else I've got. There are some times I can think where open strings are perfectly fine. You'd want to do it actually. Like in measure 5, this the end of them, that it would be weird. It'd be too much bow crossing. They go. So it's just a nice little scale. So open strings are fine, but when you get to longer notes, like in measure 7, or even like the first note, you can add just a little bit of vibrato if you're used to playing vibrato. If not, just keep it straight. A good intonation is good. But if you can use some vibrato, just a little wiggle. Just a little impulse. It's not a big, dramatic, wide, I'm dreaming. You know, it's still, I've told the other parts, it's still just a dream. It's not reality. We're not declaring it. So just a gentle, gentle vibrato, okay? And we, in general, want to sustain, even on these long notes, like measure 15 and 16, even though this is not the interesting part. So I hear your sleigh bells in the snow. Like, keep the sound going, but snow is not interesting to listen to. The other parts have some nice moving parts. So bring it down just a little bit and let those parts come through. So this is a little bit tricky, this Christmas, not to punch Christmas. So playing out your bow just a little bit. So from the beginning, save your bow here. It's because you don't want to go, get all the way down here and then have to go. So be just a little mindful of that little one quarter note that sticks out. It happens again in measure 20. It's the same thing. We don't want Christmas. All right, you get the idea. A little thing is the last note is just a quarter note, and it's just four beats. And in the click track, it all ends pretty abruptly. But if you wouldn't mind holding out the last note just a little bit longer, and so that we can just go until nothing. And then we can fade out in editing, and so that it all lines up and it all fades out nicely. If it just abruptly cuts off, it's a little sudden, a little dramatic. And we like drama, but not that kind of drama. All right, so let me look now, jump to the optional 8VA a second time. If you are, if you're gonna leave, let me just mention one thing real quick about filming. Is when you're filming, please record like this in landscape mode. Don't record like this in portrait mode. Unless maybe you're a cello, sometimes it's easier because the cello is so big it is sometimes nice to see it in this. So cellists are maybe the only exception, but if you are a cellist even and you can still film in landscape mode, please do that. And then you can use any part really with the click track. I like the one that says all the parts, so you can still kind of hear things and it makes sense what you're playing or where you are. So you don't necessarily have to have the part that's just for first violin. And then the only thing about recording is try to give yourself enough space and also have your camera kind of at eye level. I think that looks nice. Don't be like so close to the camera that you're like, all we see is your nose hairs or your, you know, you have any zits or something. We don't want to see that. Nobody, you don't want to see that on me either. And don't try not to have any like weird angles where you're way down low or like maybe the camera's way up high and we're like looking down on your bald spot or something. So just try to get the camera. I know it's tricky. About like this, we can see your whole instrument and everybody will kind of look uniform. All right, so if you're just playing the one octave, that's all I have to say. If you're gonna play the second octave, an octave higher, the second verse, an octave higher, I've got just a couple things to keep in mind. I like to start this in third position. You can go 3-4. sometimes I don't like to use fourth finger, and I try to go. You kind of punch through with your second finger. Punch through. And then this is back in third position. So kind of nice, slow shifts up and down, right? Nothing's fast. I stay in first position for this bar. Four. A nice classical shift is nice, where you slide up with your second finger. In general, all the shifts, I prefer that. Here, it's not really... It's not a soupy kind of romantic piece like that. It's more of a sentimental, like, listful... So a little bit of a cleaner shift is nice. Same thing coming down. And then here, this is a little bit of a hybrid shift, right? You can sort of slide into it a little bit, but tastefully. You like doing that. You can play fourth. It's really not that big of a deal. Right, and then this is all like the beginning. Replace it after you. Not. That's sort of what we call the romantic shift or the Russian shift. I don't think this is the place for it. The last thing, the end is just a little interesting. You don't have to play this an octave higher, right? It's measure 34. It doesn't really make sense. It is sort of carried over from the first part that plays an octave higher, but you can still play it in the same octave if you prefer, because it's sort of an unnecessary shift. So just the last couple measures here is... Now you can just play a harmonic. If you're not comfortable with that, or if it's not speaking or something, make sure your string is clean. Or you can... One, go. And then you can play it. And you can slide a little bit because it's a whole step. We always want to have a nice sort of connection to the string during the shift. It's not a jump. We're not jumping from one note to another. We're always sliding and have connection with the string. All right, so that's sort of my advice on this. Have fun, it's a beautiful melody. Try to keep it very smooth and legato. Don't be swayed by the click track that is very driving. It's a fun click track to listen to, but don't try not to play it too notey or too beady. Is that a word? Sure, you know what I'm saying. Try to have long phrases. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. So don't play I'm dreaming of, because that's what you hear in your head with the click track. All right, I think that's all I've got to say. Thanks so much for watching. I hope it's helpful. We look forward to seeing you in the part and everything all together. I think it'll be a lot of fun. And thanks for doing this. And we'll see you soon.
I hope that was informative and helpful.
Yeah, if you want to buy this product, just click right up here.
Right there.
We would also love it if you subscribe to our channel so we can keep in touch. It's right over there.
And if you want to learn more about us, click right here.
Ba-da-ba-ba-Fiddlershop.